Groovy. No way, those things are dangerous. I almost killed myself on a pair of those once. Classy. Not my style. It's that guy from the Hawaiian cop show. Bernard might like it, but it's way too tacky for me. Comfy. No time to relax. I'm trying to save the world. It's a nice, long, heavy-duty one. What an interesting mannequin. He's too heavy to carry. Hello, my silent gauze-wrapped friend. To get power to my chronogon. I guess I could wait for a lightning storm. I'm concerned about the human show. Where am I going to find a human to enter? To wear the costume and be the tentacle. There's something else about the human show. Is it really moral? It reminds me of American politics. Do you think it's strange me talking to a mummy? It's not so different from talking to specimens at med school. Except that you're a little older. My, those are nice clothes you're wearing. Is that what the well-dressed Egyptian wore? I really should go now. Call me sometime, okay? Ready to boogie down. It's the kind they have at the movies. It looks too heavy. Great Scott! You're purple.
Yes?
I couldn't help noticing you ranting.
Not ranting, plotting.
Say, you look kind of familiar.
Of course I do, nitwit. I'm Purple Tentacle, renowned world conqueror.
Are Are you the same Purple Tentacle who knew Dr. Fred?
Up on your ancient history, are you? Yes, I remember that insignificant insect.
Just exactly how well did you know Dr. Fred?
What's that supposed to mean? You're not a human sympathizer, are you?
Why, yes, I'm a firm believer in human rights.
I'd almost think you were serious.
So, what are you plotting?
I'm building a shrinking ray, which I can use to shrink those pesky humans out of my sight for good.
Tell me more about this shrinking ray of yours.
I call it the Diminuator. The biggest problem left is to design a trigger that doesn't require fingers.
If you'll excuse me, I've got something in the oven.
Anyone I know, eh? My secret weapon is almost ready.
I wonder how it can float midair like that. At least he hasn't conquered Antarctica yet. I don't want to disturb anything with Santa Claus over there eyeballing me. According to these, the tentacles control most of the world already. He looks a little older than I remember. Not wise.
My secret weapon is almost ready.
It's behind the glass.
About humans.
Honestly, sir, I think they're filthy, obscene, foul, sickening, like the stuff in your eyes when you wake up, like the wax that builds up behind your suction cups after a few days.
That's enough, son. I just wanted to be sure you weren't one of those humanist sympathizers. What with this ridiculous human show going on here, there's humophiles everywhere.
I'm no humophile, sir.
That's good. Now, let me tell you about a little plan I have.
Gosh, I hope this isn't like the primitive, dangerous microwave ovens of my century. Those things could really pop a hamster good. Uh-oh. That was fun, but only because this is the 22nd century. You see, kids who put hamsters in microwaves back where I'm from get taken away from their parents and put up for adoption. So don't do it. The This ought to warm him up.
My secret weapon is almost ready.
Although limited to a low-pressure, sub-zero nitrogen-free environment, the flux induction circuit can still be quite useful.
Don't torment me. I'm a powerful tentacle. I could have you served on a bed of rice.
Okay.
Get this show on the road.
Ah, here it comes, my finest hour.
And so I said to her, that's not my suction cup.
You think that's funny? Listen to this.
They seem to be deliberating very intensely. Although limited to a low-pressure, sub-zero nitrogen-free environment, the flux induction circuit can still be quite useful.
Man, you could really bore somebody to sleep with that.
Speaking of sleep, guess who you know who's sleeping with now?
If he can be a doctor, then I'll have no trouble. Doctor!
What is it? Is someone sick? We can't have sick humans in the show.
Well,
I examined them all myself. They're all perfectly healthy looking to me. Except for the dead one. Now leave me alone.
Thermodynamic flux induction circuit design is perhaps the most fascinating branch of practical electrical theory.
Get that book out of my face, would you?
Sorry. Hey, anybody care for a bribe?
What do you think we are, human?
Ha ha ha! Human.
I don't think that will help us win. Hey, when are you guys going to judge best smile?
Oh, all right.
Thank you.
You know, that quiet one in the bandages has the biggest smile I've ever seen.
But his teeth aren't as pearly white as Harold's.
Oh, of course, there's no comparison.
But I think we should give second place to the mummy, because he maintains it for so long.
Agreed.
Hey, when are you guys going to judge best left?
Oh, all right.
Okay, who's got a joke?
Hey, I just flew in from Baltimore, and boy are my suction cups tired.
A classic.
I think our mummy friend picked up a sense of humor somewhere.
Yes, but Harold still tops him.
Oh, of course. Harold wins hands down.
But if it weren't for Harold, I'd let the mummy have it.
Agreed.
Hey, when are you guys going to judge best hair?
Oh, all right.
Harold's got some amazing hair.
The mummy's has improved.
Yes, but it's dull, flat, stringy, lacks body and control.
Whereas Harold's flows and bounces with every subtle turn of his head.
Yes, Harold wins. If only the mummy's was a little bit better.
Agreed.
Red, white, and blue. Is that Luke coming back in again?
Thermodynamic flux induction circuit design is perhaps the most fascinating branch of practical electrical theory.
Trying to put us all to sleep so you can steal the contest, eh?
Oh, Harold, that's gross.
What are you babbling about?
You really should have told the judges if you weren't feeling well.
Oh, ick! Now, how did that mess get in there? I think I'm going to be sick.
Someone in here not feeling well?
I was feeling fine until I saw that.
Is that your regurgitation?
No, I'm an healthy human.
Didn't you just say you thought you were going to be sick?
That's just a figure of speech.
Do you realize you could have infected the whole show with human influenza?
But I just got all my shots.
You're a good-looking human, Harold, but you know the rules. You're out of the show. What a mess.
I hate cleaning up after humans.
Don't you think you should judge best smile again?
Oh, all right.
I like the quiet one with the big teeth.
There's nothing in the rules about them being white.
First place goes to the mummy.
Agreed.
Thank you. Hey, don't you think you should judge best laugh again?
Oh, all right.
Okay, who's got a joke?
I know. Why did the human cross the road?
Because his tentacle owner told him to.
It's amazing how the mummy can do that without moving his lips.
I say we give him first place.
Agreed.
Hey, don't you think you should judge best hair again?
Oh, all right.
The mummies has improved.
Yes, but it's dull, flat, stringy, lacks body and control. A human's hair should stand up, not stand out.
If only it was a little bit better.
Don't you think you should judge best hair again?
Oh, all right.
Wow, that's the best hair I've ever seen on a mummy.
Thick and full.
And juicy.
The mummy wins.
Agreed.
Well, that makes him best of show.
Let's go congratulate him.
He is very well preserved.
I'll miss his laugh.
It's time to give him his winnings and start packing up. We gotta get this whole show to Baltimore by Thursday.
Yes, our work here is done.
Well, Ted, this is where we part ways. You've certainly helped save humanity. Even though you've been dead for thousands of years, I think you're my favorite Edison.
Dinner for two at Club Tentacle? I can't wait to tell my wife.
You're free!
Free to do what?
Free to run wild through the woods like humans should.
Big deal.
I said you're free. Now get off your fat, lazy butts and start enjoying it.
Enjoy being hunted for the rest of our lives by that mustached old tentacle with a big net? If we ran off, he'd be right on our trail. If we stay here, we know we'll be warm and comfortable. Outside, we'd be eating bugs and moss.
You'll be eating my fist in a second.
The woods are filled with wild animals. Lions, tigers, and skunks. Man, I hate skunks.
Oh, here I go out the door. Oh, I do so enjoy these freedoms that my forefathers fought and died for.
Give it up.
Sheesh. He was scratching his back on the fence, I think. This ought to be good. Gee, I hope that's not lead-based paint. I can't get to it up there. Well, what do we have here? Looks like a prosthetic rodent. Another specimen.
Lieutenant, I want to ask you something. It may trouble you.
Ask away, sir. I can take it. I've got a strong stomach, nerves of steel, bowels of brass.
Sir, can it, son? This is important. Have any of your friends seemed a bit firm lately?
Ooh, ick! You mean like non-squishy and non-slimy?
That's right. Come closer. I've recently become suspicious that humans might try to infiltrate us.
No!
Though basically stupid, they can be tricky. They may be in disguise.
Ooh, a skunk, how frightening.
Hey, look, a skunk.
Come back here, you mangy humans! You can't do this! This is an escape-proof facility!
Who says you can't learn anything from cartoons, eh, kitty? I think I've had enough fun with Mr. Kitty. Now I am the jailer and you kitty are my prisoner. I doubt if I could budge it. I wonder if that still leads down to Dr. Fred's old lab. This 400-year-old clock is an amusing example of primitive human timekeeping. It looks pretty well stuck there. Good riddance. It has a door on the side. That's how you empty the vacuum cleaner, I guess. Looks abandoned. It's the same generator that was in Dr. Fred's lab. Yep, I'd say that's where the juice comes out. Fascinating. There's a face print on the glove. I hope it's sprung for good. It's done moving. It's done moving. I'm sure he's in there. Hello, Fluffums? There's a hamster in there, I think, or at least pieces of one. Well? Look at that sucker go! He just keeps running and running and running.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Mr. President, may I offer you an excellent smoke?
Can you also provide me with a light?
Sure.
Well, in that case... Blast, I hate it when that happens. See if you can't find those for me, will you? There's a good lad.
Could you use these?
Why, thank you, young man. strange. I wonder if I should cut down on the coffee.
Hey, Tom, look! The father of our nation is cold. Better build a fire.
You're right.
Huh?
I guess you can have my log.
Me? Why should I build the fire? You build the fire.
I'm bothered by the smoke. You build the fire.
I'm bothered by your attitude. You build the fire.
No, you build the fire, Mr. Penmanship.
No, you build the fire, log lover.
No, you build the fire.
No, you build the fire.
You big baby.
Excuse me. Yes? Gee, I gotta go now. Navajo, I think. He looks better now. Hi there.
Hello.
Feeling better now that there's a fire?
Much better, thank you. My teeth were grinding into a fine powder, and that blanket was really making me itch.
What's with the canary over the fireplace?
Oh, that's an early warning system. It's quite ingenious. The canary is trained to ring the bell madly the minute it smells smoke. Then we know the building's on fire, and we run like crazy.
Who thought of it?
It was invented by Red Edison, the owner of the inn.
Who feeds the canary?
Actually, no one does. It's a self-feeding canary. It's specially bred with some kind of nutrient-producing bacteria in its gizzard. It's quite a time saver. I expect everyone will have them in the future.
Well, why doesn't the fire in the fireplace set it off?
I assume it's because all the smoke goes up and out the chimney.
I see.
Amazing, isn't it?
Nice painting of a turkey, dude.
I'm glad you think so. The choosing of the national bird is on our agenda for the convention.
Well, I thought the national bird was the eagle or something.
It may well turn out to be just that. You see, there are two schools of thought on the matter. Ben Franklin and I are in favor of the turkey, whereas Jefferson and Washington, for some reason, want the eagle. But Franklin's always outside playing with his ridiculous toys instead of here where he belongs, so it becomes two against one.
What's so great about the turkey?
They've helped us to survive since we set foot on this continent. They're symbolic of prosperity and the thanks we give for our lives here. Besides, they're kind of cute.
What's wrong with the eagle?
Well, it's a bird of prey, for one thing. I don't think that's an appropriate symbol for our country.
Don't you guys have anything better to do?
Such as what?
Establish domestic freedoms?
Come on, this is important stuff.
I see.
Good.
Well, gotta go.
Goodbye.
Yo, Tom.
Thomas.
So, how's the time capsule going?
No one has brought me anything. I'm having some difficulty generating the proper spirit.
How goes the framing of the Constitution?
Great! George's suggestion about the vacuum cleaners really got the old creative juices flowing. Even as we speak, Hancock's polishing up his single-syllable undergarment amendment.
I hope they've got a good editor. Well, later, dude.
What? What's going to happen later? Thank you. This is exactly the sort of thing I need for the time capsule. I'll bury it tonight, and it won't be seen for hundreds of years. Future generations are in your debt.
Whoa.
Chateau de Cheap, 1775.
What's up? Great hat, man. Know where I could get one? Do they come in a variety of designer colors? Maybe like a gold lame or something. I don't suppose you'd consider parting with yours, would ya? Well, let me know if you change your mind. Later, dude. It's really smoking.
Fire!
Okay, who was the idiot who started the fire?
It looks pretty clear in here now. Say, did you get the pen on our way out?
No,
I found a blanket blocking the chimney.
Son, do you know anything about a blanket?
Didn't the dude next to you have one earlier? Hey, catch you later.
Thank you.
stolen from the desk of George Washington.
Ah, excellent. I need that for my super battery.
Chateau de Cheap, 1775.
For my ingenious battery. Stand back, boy. Give me room to work. Modern science. It will look lovely here on the shelf until I take it with me to Baltimore.
It's Red's battery. Don't look now, but the British are coming, dude.
Eh? Where? Is that supposed to be funny? I'm very busy.
I got something good for you, mister. Mister.
Mr. Brainstorm? Yes, hand it over. Doesn't this belong to somebody?
Yeah, Red Edison.
Ah. I'm sorry, but the man has no vision. A lightweight, durable fabric like this going to waste down in his basement. When I'm done with it, it will fly. Eureka! The all-season Francocopter, ready to make history. No, there's no fuse.
So, what do I light?
For the last time, you're not going to light anything. You just push it.
The whole time? How am I going to get up that high?
Listen, just wait for me to say the word now. Then push the kite into the air, all right?
I'm on you, Lasagna.
Let's hope so. Now! Now! Now, in the name of science, now!
Whee!
It's handling kind of funny.
You got it. Just hang on there.
She's too heavy. I can't control her.
Hang on, Ben. Hang on.
She's breaking up. She's breaking up. Run for your life! Now that was interesting.
Yeah. Say, can I see that kite for a second?
No, I'm taking it back to my lab in Philly right now so I can study the results. Wish me luck! I never got your name.
It's Hoagie, sir.
Nice working with you, Hoagie. I promise to name an invention after you someday.
Gosh, thanks. The lightning must have charged it up.
Will you please sign this contract?
I don't sign things I haven't read.
Sign it or I'll get real mad.
And do what? Not be my friend anymore? Ha ha ha.
Will you please sign this contract?
I don't sign things I haven't read.
Oh, forget it. I'll get rid of Purple Tentacle myself.
Oh, yeah? How?
Getting Purple Tentacle declared insane and arrested.
That's a good idea.
But I need a note signed by a doctor.
Oh. Hey, I'm a doctor.
We're in luck.
Well, good luck.
The party of the first part shall hereby be known as a crazed maniacal genius.
It's some kind of legal mumbo-jumbo.
Yes, what do you want?
Hi there. Is this Dr. Fred Edison?
Who did you think you called? Dr. Spock? Look, I don't have all day.
This is Farley Crockett, LucasArts Games. I just discovered your contract among some very old files, and, well, our lawyers say that we have to pay you $2 million in back royalties. For the use of your family in the Maniac Mansion video game.
What?
This is Farley Crockett.
No, I heard that, you moron. When do I get my money?
Oh, right now. It's been credited to your Swiss bank account.
Operator, get me a travel agent! This is an emergency!
Thank you. Couch Potato Shopping Channel, Wanda speaking.
I want to buy a diamond.
That will be $2 million. Do you have a major credit card?
I have a numbered Swiss bank account.
What's the number, sir?
It's 846-427-35327.
Very good, sir. We'll send the diamond by pronto post light speed delivery immediately. Thank you for calling.
Now that's service. I'd better get this to Dr. Fred right away.
That should do it. Where did you get this diamond anyway?
It was donated by a group of Girl Scouts who were in the neighborhood.
How heartwarming. According to my instruments, everything is in readiness. Your friends have activated their units, so it's time to throw the switch!
Great! Hoagie! I'm so happy to...
Hi!
Laverne! Wow! I'm so glad you two made it back okay.
I hate to interrupt, but there's no time to lose. Now that you're back, we've got to proceed with the original plan and send you back to yesterday to turn off the sledge-o-matic.
Huh?
Say what?
Now hold on a minute, Dr. Fred. They just barely made it back to our time alive, and I think...
You can't turn off the machine if I get there first.
Uh-oh.
Don't worry, guys. This time I know I can stop him.
Uh-oh. I guess we better do something.
Let's go.
No, wait! You can't all go in the same store. Didn't you see the fly?
We're some kind of monster, dudes.
Great. Stuck here the rest of my life, listening to Bernard talking and watching Hoagie eat. Mom warned me there'd be days like this.
Now, wait just a minute.
It's perfect tentacle!
It's green tentacle. What was that green?
Perfect tentacle behind you!
What?
I believe he's trying to warn you about me.
Oh.
We're going to turn off the sludge-o-matic and defeat your evil plan, overgrown worm.
You sorry lot are no match for me.
But there's three of us. Well, sort of.
Nevertheless, I mean to crush you.
Yeah?
You and what army?
Why, this army, of course.
Yikes.
You see, I've been busy. These are all versions of myself from the future. I've been bringing them back here using the Chronojog. Together, we will conquer the world. Mutant there. Go to the basement and guard the sludge-o-matic. No one is to touch the sludge-o-matic. Now, creature, I must decide what excruciating tortures to leave them to me. I've been itching for a chance to test out my newly completed diminuator.
Uh-oh.
Excuse me. Us.
All right, the rest of you come with me. Next stop, the world.
What do we do now?
Whoa.
It wears off.
Aha!
Run for it!
Damn. The battery must not have had time to recharge, but it will.
Maybe he won't find us.
Yoo-hoo! Where are you, human?
Hi there!
Perhaps if I readjust the static phrase dynamo again.
Whew.
Hey! Where'd he go? Something tells me it leads to the lab. Impressive triangular formation.
Watch it.
Excuse us.
What is it?
Would you mind hopping out to get us some Chinese food?
Nice try, but we're not budging. Now, buzz off.
Excuse us.
What is it?
Could you let us pull that lever over there?
No chance. Now, buzz off.
Excuse us.
What is it?
Which one of you is the real Purple Tentacle?
We all are, Dopey. Weren't you paying attention earlier? Now, buzz off.
Excuse us.
What is it?
Look behind you, a three-headed monkey.
The only three-headed monkey here is in front of us. Now, buzz off.
Dr. Fred, are you all right?
Get me out of here! I feel like I'm pupating!
Great! Now we can turn off the machine and prevent all this tentacle mayhem from ever happening.
Well, I'm certainly glad that's over with.
Yeah, let's get out of here.
Leaving so soon? We haven't had the chance to get to know one another. Your efforts are so tiny.
Eek!
Run all you like, you insignificant insect. My other selves are taking over the world as we speak. You can't stop me.
Are you really a future version of Purple Tentacle?
Who else would be brilliant enough to invent the Diminuator?
How is it that you can grow hair without follicles?
It wasn't easy, but the secret made me very wealthy.
You're pretty handy with that ray gun.
Center of the forehead every time. Would you like a demonstration?
No thanks, we can't afford it.
It's free of charge, unlike the Diminuator.
Are you sure you're a future version of Purple Tentacle?
I said I was, did I not?
Are you more or less intelligent than the Purple Tentacle from our time?
The same, but I've had 200 years to think things over.
Just what is it you have against humans, anyway?
Humans are our oppressors. They made us live in this horrible motel. They created us in ungainly forms, so we could not rise against them. Try walking around with your legs tied together and glue on your shoes. You'll see what I mean.
But humans also created the sludge-o-matic, which made you super intelligent.
Nonsense. I created that myself and sent it back through time. I knew Fred's mad scientist ego would make him use it. How's that for a paradox?
Who, Fred? But there's only one of him.
Right. Anyway, you can see why I detest humans.
Let's discuss your hatred of humans further.
What's to talk about? I detest the whole cackling, hand-wringing lot of you.
Sounds like you just hate Dr. Fred.
I suppose you're right about that. I didn't start out hating all humans, just Dr. Fred.
Why don't you zap Fred with the ray gun for a change?
Perhaps that would be entertaining. Oh, drat.
Surely we can talk this out.
Talk?
Surely.
I'll be back, and the next time, the world and all its piffling inhabitants shall be mine. All mine. All mine.
Okay, little fella. Mail this to Siberia. Here is done. Now we can go home.
Well, kiddies, it's been more fun than a jumpsuit full of weasels. Now, kindly get your freakish hide out of my home.
Please, Dr. Fred, you've got to get us out of this mess. We look terrible, and we can't buy clothes off the rack.
I'm getting sort of used to it. Maybe we could go on the talk show circuit.
Help us, Dr. Edison. You're our only hope.
Oh, all right. Idiots! It seems you're not exactly the sideshow attraction you imagined. You're just three complete goofballs stuck in one suit of clothes.
Well, I'm glad that's taken care of. Looks like everything's back to normal.